So second thing that you have to find out is current I. You know, V is equal to I into R, or I is equal to V by R. Here instead of R, you have to take total resistance. So that will be I is equal to V by R suffix T. What is V? Total V is 120. So 120. What is the total value of the resistance? 30 ohm. 120 by 30. So you have 4 amps. 4 amps. 4 amps is what we get. Okay? So this is you get actually for the current you got, and you got the total value of the resistance. Now you will be finding out, the individual voltages. Individual voltages. So, three things you have to find out. Okay. Voltage across resistance, fine. Voltage across resistance, phi equal to V1. Now, if you remember the voltage divider rule, the voltage divider rule will be the voltage across a particular resistor. Again, I am talking series circuit. The voltage across a particular resistor is the ratio of that value of the resistor to the total value of the resistor into total voltage. So V1 is equal to R1 divided by R suffix T into V. So R1 is 5 ohm. Total RT, that will be 30 ohm. And the total resistance value and the total voltage value 120. So 5 by 30 into 120, that will be 20 volts. 20 volts. Now V2 is equal to R2 divided by RT into V. That is 10 by 30 into 120, which is nothing but 40 volts. Next we have V3. V3 is equal to R3 divided by RT into V is equal to R3, that will be 15 by you have 30 into 120 volts. 15 by 30 will be 1 by 2. 1 by 2 will be 60 volts. You have V3 is equal to 60 volts. See what is 60 volts. This is nothing. Okay. Hope you have clearly understood this.